Good morning, Capricare family. Starting this morning off with Leandra Johnson, Endow Me. You come in, put in wonderful things. Thank you for yesterday, Don Marie Morris. Thank you for Monday. Thank you, Brian Buchanan. Hey, marvelous Monday, terrific Tuesday. Now we having a wonderful Wednesday. Those high schoolers, you should be in class. You should be in your seat. That bell is about to ring. It's complete chaos. No love, air, and guess what? Here, that I know. We do not own the rights to the music. We do want to be endowed, truly endowed. This is the day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Hashtag for the week. Restless versus tired. Restless versus tired. You can get in there. Restless versus tired. And Paul, yes, restless versus tired. Yeah. Good morning to you. Come on in. Yes. All right. Anybody know you've been endowed? How many are blessed by those who just wrap me in the cradle of his own? You don't own the rights again. Thank you, YouTube. Thank you. Come on, it's your time. Put that in. It's your time, Lord. And bring that down. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Put some things up that I haven't put up in a while. I just need you to be endowed today. And I'll get another. Y'all remember those books? Hey, I'm Bob. Good morning to you. Watch and pray. I can relate. The odds are stacked against me. Get those resources, please. Good morning, Aunt Cheryl. Good morning. Good morning to you. Yes. Those are some wonderful resources. I promise you that I bless you. Those of individuals needing IV, I promise you, wellness, cold, flu, anxiety, hangovers, migraine, and such more. Book online, ivfluids.com, or text 615-559-5090. Professional IV services. Anybody, this would be a great gift. And we make sure we are staying hydrated. Yeah. School days. Welcome to the open house. Don Marie Morris. Don, you know what? I do not have a flyer. And I need a flyer. Let's not forget school days. I promise you, you'll be blessed. Good morning, Don Marie Morris. Good morning, Cheryl. Good morning, God Bob. Endow me. Yes. Don, if you could send me the flyer really fast, I'll try to upload it to the screen. Good morning as you're coming in, tired versus. Thank you, Don. We want you, fam and son. Understand what's going on. To become a better you, you have to invest in you. Thank you, Leandria. I'm gonna bring it down, fade it on out, so we can have us a marvelous show today. Good morning to everyone. This is a day again that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Restless versus tired. You know, I'm good morning, Clarice, from the newfound state of peaches. That's all I'm gonna say. Now, when we're wrestling between these two words and we're trying to determine what are the characteristics for restless, what are the characteristics for tired, and this is something that you and I both need to be mindful of, where we are emotionally, where we are mentally, where we are physiologically, where we are physically. Am I just restless, or am I tired, or am I both? Because in order for us to be the best version of us, we're going to learn how to navigate between being tired and being restless. Tired has its own set of characteristics. Yes, it does. Tired has its own set of characteristics. And we must be mindful that when we are tired. Yeah, thank you, Clarice. What's going on, Mike? Mike, get the Bible study today so we can sing and practice our singing. Clarice comes in and said, that's right, navigating is the key. You're right. You're so right. Both of them are emotions. Let's just be honest. Both of them are emotions. And when we start dealing with, don't do that. When we start dealing with the emotional state, when we have to make decisions, when we have to go the extra mile, I can tell you, I share one thing that creates weariness and being tired is overexerting. And I hate to say this, caring beyond my capacity. I had to fix my mouth, Clarice. Caring beyond my capacity. I was going to say caring too much. And I'm just going to say it. Caring beyond my capacity. One of the things that will tire you out and not just worry you, but weary you is taking on everybody's problems. You can't do that. I mean, we were not, excuse me, we were not designed to carry everybody's problems. Let's just be honest. And when you carry everybody's problems, and when you care beyond your capacity, that will weary you. And there's a new word on Bob. There's a new word, Clarice. There's a new word. It's called compassion fatigue. Compassion fatigue. And I'm telling you, that's just where we are. And we, you and I have to learn that when we are fatigued because we care, it's not a bad thing. It's just going to make us tired. That's tired. Look, Jesus said it, come unto me. All ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For my yoke is easy and my burdens is light, and you will find rest unto your soul. So we are noticing that it's so easy to have compassion for fatigue. Has anybody? Yeah, that's a real word. Yeah. Yeah, compassion fatigue. Clarice, that's a real place to be in. Like you care. Listen, you are exhausted because you've cared. And people do not know that you really care at the level that you care and how tired it has literally made you caring for them. Yeah, I know. I'm telling y'all, you can. It's something else. When you are caring, it's something else. I mean, yeah, I'm serious. Anybody other than Clarice and I, be honest.
You have literally wearied yourself because you cared so much about something else that, listen, we didn't literally have control over. We didn't even have control over. We didn't even have control over. I mean, I wish we did, but we didn't. We didn't even have control over that stuff. And we cared and we cared and we cared. And guess what? We kept caring and we kept trying to take care of that need, which possibly could have been valid at that time. But I'm Bob. It has worn. Listen, caring and taking care of that and other people will weary us, worry us, and tire us. Yes, y'all. Trying to put this up for It'll do it. I mean, it'll do it. It'll do it. Quick, fast, and a hurry. So, I'm learning, I'm Bob, that guess what? When I'm experiencing compassion fatigue on Cheryl, compassion fatigue, and I'm weary and I'm worn, I come to a new place of decision fatigue. Somebody put decision fatigue in there for me. Yeah, somebody put decision fatigue in there for me. Because, man, when I tell you, it's easy to, you tired from making all the decisions that you made. And people don't even realize that. I'm literally tired from all the decisions I have made. I am. Especially for those who lead. I mean, we got put in a place where COVID got the best of us. And we had to make decision after decision after decision after decision after decision. And Clarice parenting teenagers and adults. Oh, my God. And being a grandparent. I mean, decision after decision after the decision after the decision after the decision after a decision. Guess what? I get tired of making decisions. I get tired of just meeting to make another decision. Keenan said, I am too, just a little. I'm telling you, that's a real place to be in. Decision fatigue, compassion fatigue. Like, I got to make another decision, April Fisher. Look, April, look at all the decisions you have to make, not for you, but for other people when your day begins. What are they going to eat? What are they going to wear? How are we going to address you? When are we going to leave? Who's going to sit in what seat? That's a real place to be in. You've made 16 decisions before 8 o'clock, where some people that you care for hadn't made a decision, hadn't made 16 decisions by the end of the day. But anyway, I got to get off here, y'all, because guess what? I got to go to a meeting and make some more decisions and be tired at the end of a meeting. And have compassion fatigue and decision fatigue and trying to just figure out what we're going to do next. Caring for people beyond my capacity, which is emotionally unhealthy. And it's good to love, but it is what it is. Hey, y'all, I'm getting off of here. I promise you, I'll be back. Probably at 12, 1 o'clock for noonday Bible study. I don't have my book in front of me, The Red Sea Rules. Hey, see you soon. Let's not forget. Don Marie, I'm in the middle of my stream. I got to upload that stuff. Let's not forget Don Marie's school days. Don Marie, if you're still on, put that in the chat so I can put it up there and post it so people can understand. How they can connect with speaking easy, flowing, and emotional intelligence. Don Marie, put that in the chat because I'm in the middle of a stream. I have to do some other things and I can't upload it. I can, but I can't, you know. But anyway, school days. Listen, Don, put that on the website. I'll come back this afternoon and do a whole nother little snippet with that. But anyway, for those who want to become a better speaker, for those who want to understand how to balance your day and your emotional intelligence, let's connect with Don Marie Morris, because guess what? I need capacity to do what I do, but I can't do it beyond my capacity because that tires me out. And guess what? I get restless when I get tired, but I can be restless and not tired. So I have to navigate. So I'm learning to navigate. That's it. All right, y'all. I'm over here. It's Capri Cares. Know that I care. Care that I know. Y'all have a wonderful Wednesday. Peace and blessings.